fossils. So fossils means suppose if any organism dies, say a goat, a dinosaur, or any plant or any other animal, then what happens? The body is decomposed. See, if human beings die, somebody goes and buries them, or somebody goes and burns their body in the graveyard, right? But if a plant or animal dies, nobody goes and buries them, and nobody goes and burns their body. Then how does it mix up with the environment? It decomposes. Bodies get decomposed with the help of decomposer organisms. Those are fungi and bacteria, and then they break down the organism into small, small substances, and later they get lost in the environment, mix up in the environment. But sometimes some body parts remain forever without decomposing. For example, skeleton. Say skeleton of the dinosaur. It did not decompose, and likewise it remained forever. Then what happens? Slowly sand, mud gets deposited over it. And then suppose if one more goat has died, then again the goat skeleton will get deposited. Like this, over a period of hundreds of years, organism's body gets deposited, and over that body sands and stone and rock develop. And then these remains of the body stay forever in the mud. So what is the meaning of definition of fossil? Fossil is nothing but the preserved traces of living organism. So these living organisms got buried inside the mud and rock, and these bodies will remain forever, which are known as fossils. So those are the preserved traces of the living organism. So the body parts are always retained either in the mud or in the rocks among the stones. So how can we determine the age of any fossil? Suppose if we are digging the earth at a shorter distance, we had found any fossil of an organism, then we can say the fossil is very young. But if we have digged the earth very deeper, we have going on digging the earth, and in a deeper layers we have found the fossil, then we can say that it is a very old fossil. So the depth also determines the age of the fossil. The next thing that determines the age of the fossil is dating the fossil. So here dating means detecting the ratios of different isotopes of same elements. Detecting the ratios of different isotopes of same element. Isotope means any atom. Element has atoms in it, right? The protons number will be same, the neutrons number will be different. Then that element is known as isotope. So here different isotopes ratio will be found. So that elements are extracted from the fossil. So from the fossil, an element will be extracted, chemical element. Then the protons, neutrons will be counted, their ratio will be seen. That is only known as isotope. So the ratio of isotopes also determines the age of the fossil. And how does fossils form? Fossils always form layer by layer. Suppose if a dinosaur has died, then it gets compressed over the sand. Then after a few years, goat has died. Its body gets compressed inside the mud, and then sand and then rocks develop over it. Like this, these are buried over a period of hundreds of years. But then due to soil erosion, due to continuous flow of water over the rocks, these rocks get corroded away, or get the top layers of the rocks or mud gets washed away due to cyclones, due to erosion. Then what happens? When these top layers are washed away, then we can see the fossils inside, that is the dead remains of the dinosaurs, the goats, etc. Or otherwise, sometimes if some insects are going on the earth, and suppose a heavy, hot, extremely hot mud has come and set on the insect, then due to the extreme hotness of the mud, the insect thereafter dies. But that insect's body will always remain there in that mud. So, and then sand, rocks kept depositing over it. But due to the erosion, if suppose mud and the sand moves away, then we will see the body remain part of the insect. That is only known as fossil. Fossils are nothing but the preserved traces of living organisms. And there are many traces of fossil organisms. Archaeologists, scientists study the fossil remains of many organisms. So this is about fossils.